the honourable member of this house representing your constituency, you have been given the mantle of being chairman of Host Community Producing Oil and Gas. How has it been, sir?
We have a task to perform, and it's clear as spelled out in our jurisdiction that is given to us. So to that extent, we are getting ready. We have been doing some underground works, but as it is now, we are doing, we're coming, I think our inaugural meeting is coming up on Wednesday, by his grace, I think at 1:30 p.m. within this premises here. So we'll reel out our plan of action and what we think we should do, how we need to engage the host communities vis-a-vis the operating companies and government itself to get the best for all parties. It's going to be a win-win situation where there'll be less downtime, less loss of man hours, because the CSR component of the activities of most of these companies is what causes some of these problems. So we want to see how we can bridge the gap and also get better and higher productivity, you know, coming from those communities, so that the country also becomes better in terms of our earnings. You would have to understand that over the years there has been so much of outcry from the host communities, and I thank the Right Honourable Speaker of this House and the leadership for using this platform of the Host Communities Committee to try to address some of these age-long yearnings of the people of the oil producing communities, especially in the Niger Delta.
So let's talk about your constituency project. You know that you have empowered a lot of people in your constituency. Can you let us know?
Well, you see, one thing, when we talk about constituency project, because out there, people see constituency project as something that people interpret it differently. But there are three things when you're elected into parliament. Representation, you're supposed to come and represent your people. And that I think we're doing very effectively. You must also come to make laws. You also have to attract development to your area. Yes, it is a difficult period. You know what COVID-19 is doing. Of course, you know the way our income in Nigeria is. We're almost at the zero level. But even at that, we've held a lot of projects and programs that will impact directly on the lives of the people. Because mine, I target the vulnerable in society. And if you go to the countryside, because my constituency is more of a constituency that has been raped, because that's where you see the bulk of oil activity. And that is the heart of Ogoniland, where it is believed that our people should die. That's what we see ourselves as, the people that have been abandoned and neglected. And so you hardly find government presence, particularly federal government presence. I say so with all sense of respect. But for the roads and bridges and all the things that have been done by the River State government, you don't see anything there. And I stand to be challenged. And so what we do is to complement what government in River State is doing through what you call constituency project. At least about a week or 2 weeks ago, a good number of persons were trained in fisheries, this aquaculture development and all that. They were trained and also empowered. They were given this collapsible, what do we call them, pumps, giving feed, giving juveniles, and giving some cash to go and start to invest on their own. I think that's about the third time we are doing that now. And some have been trained in, what they call it, they have been trained in all these cooking, baking, and all sorts of things, giving a whole lot of things to 4 burner gas cookers with ovens and some cash and all that to go and set up on their own. Now, these little activities you see, if well monitored, they are the ones that are down the trunk, down the rung. So they are the ones who are trying to bring out of complete poverty and hunger. And that's why I said we're looking at the very vulnerable persons in society. We have also intervened in schools, I think about 5 major schools for now, where all kinds of instructional materials, computers and all sorts of things were delivered to the students in those schools. We, on our own too, individually, because insecurity is what is killing Nigeria today. I have on my own built and delivered and handed over a police station, a complete police station with all the attributes of a police station. We have done that and handed over to the Commissioner of Police in River State. We are waiting final approval from the Inspector General of Police for them to deploy men there, because it's one of the largest local governments, if not the largest local government in River State in terms of land mass, and I think about the third in terms of population outside Obiakwa and Port Harcourt. But yet we have just one police division. So having one more or two more police divisions will enhance security in the area. That one is as good as done. So we have done a whole lot. We have enabled our people, I think over 300. We enabled them, we facilitated the process of them getting the COVID-19 loan that was given of 500,000. Then we also facilitated about 173 people who also got the NYSA loan. Now, we had to do everything we could to make sure that we got a consultant who got them prepared and all that, and they're all doing well. A lot of fish farms all over the place. You find people having garri processing, many industries, both for oil palm production and all that. You find tailoring and all that scattered all over the place. So each time you visit any of those people, you get so excited that these people that had nothing are now employers of labor. So we encourage them. Yes, some of them will not do very well with it. We encourage many of them to get up. So when I look back and I discover that this much has been done, particularly in the area of human capital development, I feel very, very fulfilled. Because I can sit here now and call back home, and I'll call somebody and say, look, can you give 100,000 to somebody? That person you are calling is the same person that was looking for 5,000 naira yesterday. But you can today boast of carrying 100,000 and give to somebody on your behalf. Then you cannot be able to say, when you come around, you say, come and take your money. Do you understand? So you see that funds are now available to the people. They took advantage of those packages of government through the CBN, and they have been able to leverage on it. A good number of them are doing very, very well. So to that extent, I think that's what we talk about. Representation, I have been able to do that to a great extent, and I stand to be challenged. Without looking back, I believe that before we run through this period of 4 years, by the grace of God, we'll do a lot more that will bring development to our place. At least for now, in the budget of this year, we have a lot of water projects. We have some issues that we have to do with education. We also have some road and other things, interventions in electrification and all that in this 2021. And by the grace of God, in a number of days from now, some days from now, we have been interfacing with the Federal Minister of Power, and will be visiting River State, that's my constituency, to take a look at how best and how to intervene in the issues of electricity in my constituency particularly. So those are the little things we are doing. We are still doing many more.
Finally, in the next few years, how do you see your constituency in terms of economic growth and development?
Well, you know, I'm coming from a place where, like I said, we have been raped. And we are made to understand that peaceful demonstration amounts to nothing. Because when I sit back and I hear of banditry and all kinds of things that is going on, the dangerous headsmen who are coming from, we hear, other parts of the continent and coming to Nigeria and all that, and causing all the things they're causing. Sometimes I begin to wonder, when you hear of Boko Haram and all that, what exactly are they fighting for? If you take a visit to Ogoniland, you will understand why we have been agitating. With leaves, just leaves every day, crying to the world that these are the people that are going into extinction. Have you been to Port Harcourt lately? If you go to Port Harcourt, you will weep because the black suit has taken over the entire place. The health challenges, attendant health challenges from this level of contamination of our area, the entire place, is so frightening. So when you look at things like this, we only hope and pray that it does not continue in this way. When most times we see the governor of River State virtually crying, they don't understand. You need to go to where we come from so that you feel the pain. And I ask, here is a country we all belong to. What is the magic that the governor of River State has put in place that makes it possible that even under COVID-19, projects are embarked on, completed, and new ones are coming up and they are completing them? I think that at the national level, we should look inwards and place proper pegs in proper holes. Let us rebuild this country. That's the only way my people will benefit. Because I say it every day. If we say we want to reorganize NNPC, reorganize this agency and all that, we're just wasting our time. Let us sit together. Keep the entity called Nigeria, but let us review it and look at how best we can work and live together as a country. The earlier we do that, the better for us. Because if you look at this issue of banditry now, it has overrun almost all states as we're seeing them today. Look at Katsina, look at Zamfara, look at Sokoto. What's happening in Nigeria? Is it that we're not seeing or we're not hearing? Or is it that there's something that is behind the scene that we are yet to be made to understand? If what is happening in Nigeria today is not planned, then the APC government must rise up to save the little that is left of the entity called Nigeria. If we don't do that, this calamity that is befalling us will swallow all of us. I say this every day because I want the ordinary man on the street to understand that is my own position. I attended the Federal Government College and I have friends and brothers all over Nigeria. This has nothing to do with religion. It has nothing to do with your tribe. What we have to do now is let us save the entity called Nigeria.